One of the situations we had recently come in to the Team Clark Consumer Action Center, if you're not aware of what that is, it's where you can get one-on-one advice and information and guidance 30 hours each week for free from our team members, both paid and volunteers. And just 2 weeks ago, we had our latest installment of somebody losing their own home to squatters. And this is something that has lots of wrinkles to it, but it's become a thing. And there are people on TikTok and other social media posting how easy it is and how great it is for you to just be able to help yourself to somebody else's home. One of the people who contacted us recently had gone on a one-week vacation and came home, and there were people living in his home who changed the locks. And the police said, well, nothing we can do about this. And this is happening in various states around the country. The biggest problems of all happening in Georgia and Texas, where the laws are really essentially silent. If I go into your house, break into your house, and steal something from your house, let's say I go in and help myself to your TV, and I'm walking out with your TV, I have committed a criminal act. If I'm arrested and charged, I did the crime. I have to do the time, right? How about instead, and this is a problem state after state after state, if I go into your house, move in, help myself to the food in your refrigerator, watch that TV, sleep in your bed, whatever, in so many states around the country, I have not committed a crime. It is considered to be a civil problem. The owner of the house has to go to court and try to get you evicted from the home. That could take months, as has happened with these ugly celebrated cases around the country. And, there was the one in California with Airbnb. I'm going to talk about that in a second, where somebody moved into an Airbnb for a three-day stay and stayed, I think, 2 years. And this is so in the news of the weird. Couple of things. One, it's not like this is going to happen to all of us. It's not even going to happen to a meaningful percent of us. But when it happens to you, and you have worked hard to buy this home, and suddenly you can't live in your own home because somebody else invited themselves in and is living in that home, this is just absolutely atrocious. And there are a number of angles to this. One, we get so many questions about where somebody commits fraud, pretends to be you, and they look for homes that are owned free and clear, and they are able to convince the local government, convince lenders that they're the rightful owner of the house instead of you, and they take ownership of the home, they borrow money against the home, and that has many different layers where someone's just trying to commit financial fraud and grab money against a paid off home, or they want to go further and they want to steal the home. The second case we had in the last couple of weeks, the one 2 weeks ago, was one where someone did that. They committed fraud and they took out debt against the home and they took control of the home, and the people who had owned the home, all the police would do is evict the actual real homeowners because the paperwork said that the crook was the proper owner of the home. I mean, we have an ugly, ugly mess here. Most of the time, this occurs with vacant homes, and particularly a situation where maybe an aging relative has gone into assisted living or they have passed away, and the home's just sitting there unloved. That's the most common circumstance where a home is stolen. And I want you to know, if you are the adult children of an aging parent who goes into assisted living or who does pass away, and you now have the responsibility of the house, you want to get that house occupied. You don't want it sitting vacant, because you're creating the possibility of a squatter taking possession when that house is sitting empty. Believe it or not, there are people who are watching the obits, and then they're trying to figure out if there's a house owned there that is sitting empty that they can help themselves to. Having the property loved and rented out, at least in the interim, is a really wise thing. Having cameras on location to make sure nothing crazy is going on there is a great idea with any vacant home. The Airbnb angle is definitely news of the weird. So weird that there's now even an obscure insurance policy you can buy for loss of income while you're trying to get a squatter out of your Airbnb. I mean, this has so many layers. And Krista, you and I have talked about this a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And the big problem here, the wide open opportunity, is the laws in state after state are not explicitly written to make it a crime to move into somebody's house and help yourself to it.
Yeah, and people are also like on TikTok exploiting this, telling people how to do it. It's really spreading like wildfire. It's crazy.
So the Daily Mail compiled states this is happening in, and I mentioned Georgia and Texas are the two most common.
Yeah, in California.
It's happened in California, New York, Florida, trying to remember where else. And vacation-oriented properties or seasonal properties are very much at risk, because people get kind of a sense of, oh, those people don't live here for months each year.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just go in and help themselves to your place. Again, cameras useful and helpful. Something we're doing at Clark.com is we're putting up a briefing about this. And in the states that are affected, if you live in them, you need to contact your elected representative, your state legislator, your state senator, your assembly person, whatever it's called in your state, and tell them you want any squatter statute passed. I guess this is one of those things that didn't really occur to people.
Yeah,
we went through a squatting era. I think it was in the late 1800s that squatting was really in the United States. And suddenly it's in again.
Yeah.
And the laws are behind on this. And it's something that is not a major piece of legislation. It's not a controversial piece of legislation. It just needs to become it. One of the things we've learned in the ones that we've been involved in with our Team Clark Consumer Action Center is the laws, because they're silent, basically operate where they are to the benefit of the squatter, not the homeowner. And again, we've got a lot of things we have to worry about in life. This is not one people should
right.
be worrying about.
But this is one we feel like needs action taken. Like, we are really, and we want everyone to try to take action on this. So we do have a sample letter on Clark.com that you can send to your state representative, whatever it ends up being, if you want to. And we really hope that people will do this and look into this, because it's crazy.
This is absolutely crazy. And because there's no lobbyist behind fixing it, truth is, legislative members, really their ears are attuned to what lobbyists are asking for. So this is a case where constituents have to rise up and make noise, and then it becomes a priority. And this will be fixed. It's just the people who suffer in the meantime, that's what's not okay.
So if you want to see that letter and you want to take action, go to clark.com/squatters.